I'm here today with my one of my other hats on, which is the medical director of the Terence Higgins Trust. It's a national HIV testing week, and it is a real pleasure to have Taiwo Owatemi and Luke Pollard join us, and we're all going to do an HIV test together. But I'll ask both of them to introduce themselves and maybe say a little bit about why they're here this morning. So I'll come to Taiwo first.
Thank you, Michael. Hi, I'm Taiwo Owatemi, the MP for Coventry Northwest, and thank you so much for having me today. As a pharmacist, I understand the importance of ensuring that we get tested for any illness, and HIV is a very serious illness, and it's important that we ensure that we are up to date to be able to access any treatment when necessary. So I'm here to support the organisation because I believe that it's important that we keep up to date with all our sexual health screening.
And hello everyone, my name is Luke Pollard. I'm the Member of Parliament for Plymouth, Sutton and Devonport, and I'm Plymouth's first ever out MP, and I use that platform to talk about some of the issues that people sometimes don't want to talk about, and sexual health is one of those. And I think it's really important that people know their HIV status and know that getting a test is quick, easy and simple, and that's why I want to take one myself today to show how easy it is, so people wherever they are in the country, whether in a big city or in a rural area, know how they can access an HIV test.
Thank you both, and thanks for giving up your time. And I know you're both very busy, and we're really, really grateful for having you with us. So I'm going to say just a few words about why it's important, and then we're going to launch into doing our test. So as I said, it's National HIV Testing Week. This is an annual week when we use the opportunity to raise awareness about the importance of HIV testing. We have a commitment in this country, a government commitment, to end HIV transmissions by 2030. And 5 or 10 years ago, none of us would have ever said that with any confidence. Now that target is completely achievable. But to achieve it, we have to do better at testing. This country, we have been really good at HIV testing, but we still need to do more. About 8% of all of the people living with HIV in the UK are undiagnosed. They don't know that they're HIV positive, and that's about 8,000 or 9,000 people. If you don't know you're HIV positive, you can't access the amazing treatments we have for HIV now. You can't get the benefits of therapy, which will keep you well. HIV therapy nowadays means that people living with HIV can expect a normal life expectancy. They won't get ill from HIV. And also, perhaps even more importantly, in terms of our target to end HIV transmissions, people on HIV therapy cannot pass the virus onto their sexual partners. But you can't get the benefit of that unless you know your HIV status, which is why HIV testing is so important. Also, if you're HIV negative, it's really important because we have great ways of keeping people HIV negative now, such as PrEP. So if you have a test and you know you're negative, you can access PrEP, which is now freely available on the NHS, and ensure that you stay negative. So what we're going to do today is what's called an HIV self-test. There are loads of ways to get an HIV test. You can go to an HIV clinic, sexual health clinic, you can get one at your GP, you can go online and order one yourself. And there's a number of different ways that you can do a test at home. There's called a self-sample, where you get sent a kit at home and you do a finger prick test, post it off to the lab, and you get your results a few days later. But what we're going to do this morning is called an HIV self-test, which is where you do the test yourself and then read the result yourself, a bit like doing a pregnancy test. Now, as I said, there are different technologies. This is the test that we're going to use. They all work in a similar way. So I'm going to just sort of prime Taiwo and Luke now. Are you ready to do your test? You have the equipment in front of you. Great. So I'm going to talk you through what we need to do. So we've all washed our hands now. So we've done that already. One was that we prepared earlier. Now, this is a finger prick test. So the other thing, tip about getting a good finger prick test is you need to make your hands as warm as possible. So get the blood flow well. So you can squeeze the fingertips, rub your hands together, run them under a hot tap. So that gets the blood flow going. Now with this kit, now this is, it must be said, if you're going to order a test kit, and my other thing in case I forget to say, if you want to know how to order a test kit, you can go onto the Terence Higgins Trust tht.org.uk website, and we have a test finder, put it in your postcode, and that will tell you how you can order a postal kit. The ones that come in the post look slightly different from this, so follow the instructions when you get it. So this is the kit we use. It has an inbuilt lancet, so it has, you'll see, a green bit at the end. So the first thing to do is to twist that and pull it out. So we get rid of that green bit. And to do the finger prick now, as we can see this, we have a grey bit. So the needle is hidden in there. It's kind of on a spring-loaded thing. So what we're going to do in a second is press our fingers against that, and the needle's going to pop in and out and get a finger prick of blood. It means that it's completely safe and enclosed, so you can just throw the box away and you've got no problems with sharps. And then I'll show you let me see if we can see this. We're going to put a drop of blood into this little well. We're going to put some liquid on it, and then we're going to leave the test to run and read them later. So we're ready to go? So we just squeeze your finger prick, get lots of blood in there, and then press it against the gray thing. And it'll pop out. I'm not going to show that to screen in case you're squeamish. And there's a little grey lip that you just touch up against the blood that's on your fingertip. Are you good? So you've got a little drop of blood on the fingertip. Just touch it onto that little grey spout that's sticking out, and then the blood will automatically sort of move down that little tube. And then, let me just get a bit of cotton wool. You move this arm over, so the little grey tube that's got your blood in it is over the little well. We good? Luke?
How much blood do you need in there, Michael?
Have you got it? Are you struggling? So if you get one drop on your fingertip should be enough, then just touch the drop against that little grey tube that's sticking out of the handle. It should naturally just go down into the little tube. That's the just to fill up that little tube is all you need.
Great. And then you push it down.
Then that's right. So then move the little arm over and it clicks into place. So the little grey tube that's got the blood on is now sitting in the little well. Then you get your little bottle of liquid. Are you both at that stage?
Yes, I'm just trying to fill in a bit of blood.
Yep.
The thing I'd say is that if somebody's ordered the test kit, there are videos online that you can follow to show you what to do. There's instructions that come in the pack, and all of the test kits have online videos to show you how to do them. You okay, Taiwo?
Yes.
You there? Grand. Yes. So now we've got a little bit of buffer. So we need to put four drops, 1, 2, 3, 4 drops into that little well, and then basically the buffer liquid mixes with a little drop of blood, and it's now going to move up through this cartridge through a bit of filter paper that's sitting within it. So we now just set that aside, and that takes 15 minutes to run. Most of the self-tests that you do will take about 15 minutes. They've pretty much all got two lines on them, and you can see on this cartridge that we're doing, there's a T and a C. C stands for control and T stands for test. So this is the same pretty much for all self-tests. For it to have worked, you have to have a line at C, at control. That tells you that the test has worked. If you don't have a line at C, the test hasn't worked, so you can't read it. So you have to have a line at C. And then if you have a line at T, that means it's come back positive. So two lines is positive. And if you don't have a line at T, it's negative. So one line is negative. Now, the other couple of things that I would say about these is you have to remember there's a concept of a window period with an HIV test. So with these tests, it's 12 weeks. So this means the test will tell you your HIV status up to 12 weeks ago. So if there's anything that's happened more recently, you need to repeat the test when you're further than 12 weeks away from whatever you're concerned about. And the other thing is that these tests are very, very accurate, but they have a small rate of false positives. Now they're made so they're a little bit oversensitive, so you don't get a false negative. So if somebody's HIV positive, it doesn't tell them that they're HIV negative, but it varies from test to test, but about 1 in 1,000 you get a false reactive or a false positive. So any positive test, any two lines on a test like this, has to be confirmed by a blood test in the kidney. So your tests are running?
They are, yes.
So you can just set those aside and read them in 15 minutes. Unfortunately, we're not going to have time on this recording to read them, so we'll leave you to read your own results. And a reminder for anybody, I guess, that you know, if you're negative, there are plenty of good ways to stay negative, condoms and PrEP. And if you get a positive result, go to a clinic and get a confirmation. And then if you are HIV positive, you can access really effective treatment. So was that easy? How was that for you?
Straightforward, yeah.
It's remarkably easy, isn't it, really? to do one of these things. And also it means for lots of people, I remember I've been watching It's a Sin this week with the volume turned up, and I remembered that when I was a young lad, I watched Queer as Folk, a similar type of, you know, amazing piece of television with the volume so low in case anyone heard me, that actually if you are sensitive about family knowing about it or worried about it, that a simple test like this is really simple to be able to do in private.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, these self-tests have really revolutionized HIV testing because they take away a lot of those barriers that people feel. You know, it is embarrassing to go to a sexual health clinic. You know, so you don't have to with these tests. You can do them confidentially and in private at home. It's interesting that you mentioned that It's a Sin. I can't, I've binge watched it now, actually. I can't remember where we're at on the normal TV, but I think that scene where they go for an HIV test has aired now. And it's really powerful seeing that and remembering how distressing and anxiety making it was to go for an HIV test in those days and wait 6 weeks to get a result, and knowing that if you were HIV positive, there probably wasn't anything that we could do about it then. And for most of those young men and young women that were diagnosed in those days, you know, it was a death sentence, and now it's not, because a positive result means that you can access those really effective treatments. But the great thing about It's a Sin is that it's raised awareness and it's getting a lot of people to test, which we're really grateful to all the cast and crew and also to T. Davis for not just a great piece of drama, but something that raises the awareness about HIV.
Michael, can I ask, I represent a seat in the Southwest, and people often have impressions of what the Southwest looks like, bowling countryside, beautiful beaches. But we have folks with HIV here who know about it and folks who don't know about it. And sometimes there's an impression that these services, HIV testing, is only available if you live in a big city, London, Manchester, Brighton, something like that. But it's available everywhere, isn't it? So no matter where you live, if you live in the biggest urban area or in a one house village somewhere in the countryside, you can get a test now.
Yeah, tests are available everywhere. I mean, everywhere does have a sexual health clinic somewhere, but that's been one of the problems in the past for parts of the country like yours, which are rural or large counties, which might, you know, your local physical testing centre might be 50 miles away, and it's another barrier to testing. So the other great advantage of postal testing, being able to order a kit online to be sent at home, means that it makes it accessible to you wherever you live, whether you live, you know, in a large rural area, many, many miles away from a sexual health clinic, or whether you live in a large city where there are loads of sexual health clinics. So it definitely opens up testing for everybody, irrespective of where they live.
Brilliant. Michael, can I ask that, how simple is it for people to follow the instructions on the testing? Because looking at it, I found that the pictures and the steps were rather straightforward for me.
They are very straightforward. I mean, I think when people do it for the first time, it's a little bit unusual because it's not something that we're used to doing. But you'll find that whatever kit you get, as you said, very simple pictorial. This is, or I've torn mine by mistake, but anyway, you get step-by-step diagrams, and as I said, you also get a video which makes it easier, I think, that you can, because you can see what you're doing, and perhaps makes it easier if English isn't your first language, or getting information through a written form is not your preferred way of seeing it. The other thing I would say is that a lot of services can talk you through it, so certainly if you're struggling with it, for example, we have a telephone support line at the Terence Higgins Trust called THT Direct, and they would be very happy to talk people through how to do the test as well.
That's excellent. And so while this thing's doing its thing, I'm looking out for one line or two lines, and the little box at the bottom that says HIV is just the identifier of what type of test kit it is, but it's the lines that matter. Is that right?
Exactly, yes. So actually, on other tests, it doesn't have the words HIV, and on this one, it does. I think that's just to identify what kind of test it is. So whatever test that you're doing, it's the lines that are important. Again, it's very similar to a pregnancy test. Great. Well, we'll leave those to cook. It just remains to me really just to thank you both for your time and for your commitment and support. I mean, I guess the final bits that I wanted to say is that we've demonstrated how easy an HIV test is. I would encourage people who perhaps don't know so much about HIV to find out more. It's really great to have parliamentarians like yourself supporting our work, supporting the work of the HIV Commission, another great report, if people haven't read that, to have a look at that, which talks about how we can take steps across government, across the Department of Health, across the country to end HIV transmission by 2030. And testing is the beginning of that. So thanks very much for your time and commitment to the cause as well.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thanks so much for having us.
Cheers.